My husband has been my everything. We don't have kids, and I'm okay with that, because I love being with him. One evening, he was baking for me, because that's what he does sometimes. And we ran out of butter. So he went down to the bodega to go get some. And he walks in, and he didn't notice that Mr. Morales was being held up at gunpoint. And being Ken, he's gonna talk the gunman down. And he ends up getting shot. The paramedics told me that he tried to hang in there for me, but he didn't make it. And he's gone. You know, people, they've been really, really nice. You know, they've been coming by the house, and they've been bringing me food and sitting with me. And for a minute, I really thought I could survive this, you know? I can do this. But it's been 6 months now, and phone calls have slowed down, and people don't really come by like they used to. And so I'm just left here, alone, just being surrounded by him and shirts and smell. I still have a recording on my phone, you know, a voicemail with his voice on it, and I just keep playing it over and over and over again. It's hard. It hurts. It hurts to smile without him or wear bright clothes. And I feel like I'm betraying him if I even think about moving forward with anything. So I don't make decisions. You know, people can say some really stupid shit. Like, be strong, my sister. Mm. Oh, time heals all wounds. Oh, he's in a better place. Oh, you're still young. You can find somebody else. Like, really? And people like, they really like to repeat this one. God doesn't give you more than you can bear. It's enough to make you want to just sock somebody in the eye, you know? And the all-time favorite, I know what you're going through. No, you don't. No, you don't. You don't know what I'm going through. When you can tell me how do you fall asleep at night? Or do you have trouble getting up in the morning? You know, because I still sleep on that one side of the bed. And what do you do when you get invitations with both of your names on it? And when is a good time to clean out this closet? You know, I still can't go to family functions because he has a brother that looks just like him. People keep telling me, you know, you need to move on with your life. That's funny because I have to go down to the police station every 2 weeks because they still haven't got the bastard that fucked up my life. Not that I want to really move on, you know. How long do you grieve? What's the appropriate time?